guest I am, and eager. Okay, hey you guys, Mr. Rugi here, and this is my new braid out routine or regimen. I love to do my hair in this way because it works for my schedule, it works for my hair and my hair texture. And what I have going on here is I just washed my hair and I conditioned it, but I did not wash all of the conditioner out, so it still has a little bit of conditioner in it. And I'm adding more moisturizer to my hair as I re-braid my hair, because I would never do my braid out with that frizzy look at all. Because when I braided my hair for washing, I didn't braid it tight. I just braided it so that, you know, my hair wouldn't retangle or anything like that. And so once I do that, I comb it all out, I re-braid it, and I usually corn roll the front, because I don't want to deal with my bangs, because I have bangs in the front. And the only time I really deal with my bangs is unless I flat iron my bangs or I flat iron my hair, all of my head, then I'll deal with my bangs. But other than that, I just braided. I have never had any issues with that. I just don't really pay attention to my bangs that much. I know some people don't really want to cut their hair or cut their bangs because of that reason, but I like bangs when I straighten my hair out. So now I am just continuing to braid, and I'll brush so I can get the smoothest braid possible. And I add about a quarter size of moisturizer or conditioner for each braid. That's just about as much as I need for my hair to really be set in the braid. So when I'm taking it out, it has a really nice crinkle to it. I'm on my last braid. I kind of left to go watch a movie with my fiance, and I did my hair, the rest of my hair, while watching the movie. And I'm braiding my hair and cornrowed my hair in different areas, and I cornrowed in areas where I felt like I wanted fuller hair, because as we know, when you cornrow your hair compared to just simply braiding like I'm doing here, it will be fuller in that area. And when I have my hair this way, I never wear my hair out really that way. Maybe sometimes I will, but I usually wear my hair in two styles once I've braided it. And the two styles are two pigtails straight back, like braided back. So I braid my braids back. I'll just braid it all the way to the end, and I'll wear my hair like this for about 3 to 4 days. Sometimes I wear it for a whole week until I need to wash my hair again. If my schedule is really busy and I don't have time to really deal with my hair, I will wear it just like this now. Now, the other style I will do it in is the crown, and I'll show you that a little bit further in the video. You'll see me. But this is the easiest way that I can deal with my hair at this moment. As it gets longer, I don't know if I'll change my routine again. I probably will. And all I'm doing is just pinning the ends so that it will hold in place. You don't have to do that. You could actually use a ponytail holder, which is that right there, and put it on the ends right there. And that's how I wear my hair a lot of the times. Now, if I don't want to wear my hair that way, I will just wear it in a crown, and that means I just pull and pin my ends under the other side of the braid so they're protected and up and off of my shoulders. And I actually wear my hair more like this than I do the pigtails, because I feel like my ends are more protected this way, so I will wear it like this. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's so simple and so boring, and I like styles that are simple and boring, but if I'm ready to change it up, I can change it up quickly, and that's with this style. I can really do that. And this day is actually 3 days later from when I actually braided it originally. We're about to go out to do some stuff, so I wanted to take my hair out. And when I take my braids out, I always condition my hair. You don't have to use a moisturizer that I'm using. You could use some oils or whatever your favorite oil to moisturize your hair. And once I take my braid out, I don't comb or detangle my hair for the rest of the week. So if I'm only 4 days into the week, the rest of the days, the 3 days, I do not comb my hair. I just let my hair be what it is. Natural, curly, kinky, nappy. That's what I do. I have no problems with it at all. You guys have to learn to style and comb your hair with your fingers and not so much with the comb. Because I think sometimes we tend to want to use a comb and a brush as a cripple to style our hair, but we don't really need it. And the only reason why I realized this was because I did the no comb challenge last year, and I realized that all this time I have been using the comb to do different things like parting my hair, combing my hair. It just was not necessary. I really didn't need to do that. So I don't use the comb or the brush as much as I did before. And in all, it probably took me, I don't know if I said this earlier, in all it took me about 30 minutes to braid my hair, and it only took me about 15 minutes to take it down. And I like to braid my hair in smaller, well, they're not small, I won't say they're small, about maybe, I want to say between 10 to 15 braids on my head, just because it makes it easier for me to do the crown, and it makes it easier for me to braid my hair backwards into the kind of, I want to say French braided braids look, yeah, instead of just doing like 8 or 4. Okay, so that's it, you guys. That's all that I really do to my hair now. It's a lot more simple, and it's a really easy way to take care of your hair. You don't have to do much. You don't have to comb it. You just moisturize it and then pin it back up, and that's all I do. So hopefully that will help you guys in planning your own regimen and routine, and I'll see you beautiful people later. Peace. Let's start.